Hello everyone. So today we'll start with the database application development. So here you will be studying like how we can connect the application to a database. So when we say database application means there you have to design the forms or the web pages or the Windows forms through which a user can interact, and then you have to store lot of information related to that application in the database. Now how application can connect to a database, so that we will see in this chapter. And then what all the mechanisms exist to retrieve or modify the data. Like for retrieval we use SQL, embedded SQL, SQLJ, then dynamic SQL, then we can use the stored procedures if you are extending the dynamic queries. Then we can use the stored procedures, and then to handle with the result set, we use the cursor. Okay, so these are the topics which I am going to cover in this lecture. So when you use SQL in your application, that means you have to access the database, means the usually application program will be written in general purpose programming languages. Now how you will access the database, or how you will perform some operations on the data which is there in your database. So for that you have to use the query language, right, to access the database. To perform some operations on the database you have to use the query language, but only using query language you cannot implement your application. So you need a certain general purpose programming language. Now usually in the application we will use the general purpose language, and the SQL statement, so the commands can be embedded within that programming, high level programming language. Okay, so SQL commands can be called from within a host language. Okay, here host language means like where you are embedding the SQL commands. For example, it may be like C program or Java, C++. Okay, so in that you will be embedding the SQL commands. Now these SQL statements which you have in the host language, it can refer the variables declared in those languages. Okay, for example, you have used C program and there you have declared some of the variables, correct? So those variables can be referred within SQL statements. Okay, and you have to write how you can connect to the database, the correct database you have to connect, so that you have to include in the application programs. Now there are different approaches available, like how you can embed these SQL statements in host language or high level languages. Like we have embedded commands, okay, like our database commands are embedded in general purpose programming languages, or you can use the APIs or libraries. Okay, so library of database functions can be used which are available to the host language for the database calls. Okay, so these database calls can be referred as APIs, application program interfaces. Okay, APIs. Now when you use the SQL commands in general purpose programming language, then there will be a problem. Okay, for example, the data type may not match. If you take SQL, there is an integer type, but the size of the integer value may differ with respect to your C program data type. Okay, that's why you need to see how you can match these data types. So you can go for typecasting. Okay, and then another problem is when you use SQL commands, the result of any query, it will return multiple rows or multiple tuples. So you will get result in terms of tuples. The set of tuples will be fetched as a result of the query. Now how you will assign these values to a variable? Because in host language you have variables which can hold only one value, That means it can take single value. But how you will assign these multiple values to a variable which can have only single value? Okay, so these two problems are referred as impedance mismatch. Okay, so these two problems, that is the incompatibilities between your host language and the database model. So this incompatibilities is called as impedance mismatch. Now we'll see the first one, embedded SQL, like how you can put the SQL commands to any general purpose programming language. So here most SQL statements can be embedded or it can be included in general purpose host programming language, such as like C or Java, C++, Python. Okay, so in that you can include the SQL statements. Now when you include the SQL statement in high level language, you need to use certain constructs or the statements to differentiate, like to differentiate from which line onwards your SQL statement will start. You need to tell the parser or the compiler like how it can be executed, whether it has to be compiled using host language compiler or your query engine. Okay, so how it will be executed, how to differentiate. For that we will use execsql. So after execsql, you can write the statements which can be passed or compiled by your SQL engine. Okay, query query processor will check that. And then you need to end that block using end exec. So execsql end exec, or it depends on your language. In some other languages it may be like execsql begin and execsql end. Okay, it depends on the language which you use for writing the queries. Now here a preprocessor, it will convert the SQL statement into special API calls. It has to be executed and it has to access the database, right? So the preprocessor will convert those SQL statements to the database calls, which are called as APIs. Then a regular compiler, that means if you are using C, means C compiler. Okay, so that compiler will be used to compile the statements which you have written in general purpose programming language. Okay, so preprocessor, it will convert that into SQL statements, it will convert SQL statements to APIs. And then regular compiler, it will convert the host language statements. Now there are different constructs available in the embedded SQL, like execsql connect. It is used to connect the database. Then to declare a variable, we have execsql begin declare section and execsql end declare section. Then we have a statements like we have to execute some query, then we'll use execsql. Okay, execsql then end exec. So that is the construct, or these are the different blocks we are using in the embedded SQL. Now we'll see the example for embedded SQL. Here we are embedding the SQL statements in C language. Okay, so you can see the declare section. So declare section starts with execsql begin declare section, and after this you have to define the variables of your host language. Okay, so fname, lname, address, ssn, birth date, department number, then again sql code, salary. So these are the variables which are declared using your host language syntax. And then in here, what actually we are doing here is, user will enter one SSN. Okay, user will enter SSN, and for that SSN will compare with the database. In the database we have employee relation. We'll check whether that SSN is matching with any of the tuple in the employee relation. If it matches, such tuples from such tuples will display F name, L name, address, and salary. Okay, so you can see here. Prompt function, it prompts the user to enter the SSN value, and then your query will be written within the exec SQL construct. You can see exec SQL and end exec. So your query must be enclosed within this block. So here we are selecting F name, L name, address, and salary, and then normally how you will write in your C program, just you will assign some value to a variable, correct? So here F name, L name, address, salary are the values which are fetched from the employee relation, and these will be assigned to the variable which you have mentioned in the declare section. Okay, so these are the host variables. So host variables can be referred inside the SQL statement, but you have to precede that variable with colon. Okay, so all these variables are preceded by colon. You can see colon F name. That means you are referring the host variable in SQL command. And then so F name will be copied to this, L name is assigned to L name, address to the host variable address, and salary to the host variable salary. And then what is the condition? Condition here, SSN must be equal to whatever user has entered. So here you can see in the prompt, see here I'm not using colon because this is outside this block, right? So not like how you access your host variable. So similarly, you can write in this statement, okay, directly you are accessing this. But if you are accessing these variables or referring these variables within exec SQL block, then you have to use colon. Okay, SSN equal to colon SSN. This SSN is the host variable. Now here one more thing you have to see, SQL code. So SQL code is used to check the error code. Okay, it is used to check the error code. So if it is zero, that means there is no error. If it returns negative numbers, okay, if it returns negative value or the number, then there will be an error. There will be an error. Okay, so here SQL code equal to zero means there is no error. So you just display these values. Okay, like F name, all these. Whatever you have fetched from the employee relation, so those will be displayed. See, this statement is C statement, right? C program statement. That's why directly you can write SSN F name and all. No need to put the colon. Okay, and then if it returns negative value, that means that SSN does not exist. And then again, if you want to continue, you can continue by pressing 1. Okay, so if you want to check some other SSN values, then you can continue with the loop. And finally, end this block using end exec. Now the next is cursor. See, in the previous example, at a time only one row we are fetching, right? If SSN is a unique value, it is a primary key, that's why at a time you will get only one tuple. But if the result contains multiple tuples, if the result contains multiple tuples, then how you will assign those values to your host variable? For that, we use the mechanism called cursor. Okay, so when you write code for a transaction where the result set includes several rows of data, then you have to declare and use a cursor. Okay, so here you can see in the host program, you have a program variable which can hold only one value at a time, but your DBMS or your query in the embedded SQL, if you have written some query to fetch, then the result may contain multiple rows. Now, how to assign this multiple rows to a host variable? So, Cursor bridges the gap between the value-oriented host program and your set-oriented DBMS. Now, how this will work? So, Cursor, if you have a cursor, so it will point to the first row in the result set. So, at a time, it will fetch this row and the value will be assigned to your host variable. Then it will move to the next one and it will fetch the second one. So, like that, it will continue until it reaches the end of this result set. If there is no data font, then it will stop. A cursor is a mechanism you can use to fetch rows one at a time. And it is an entity that maps over a result set and establishes a position on a single row within the result set. As I said, at a time it will point to one of the tuple, and then from that tuple or the row you will fetch the values, and that can be assigned to the host variable. So after the cursor is positioned on a row, operations can be performed on that row or on a block of rows starting at that position. Okay, so here we are checking like how we can position the different rows, or sorry, different position a pointer to different rows. What actually cursor will point to one row, it will fetch that tuple and you will perform the operation, then it will move to the next one. Okay, basically the fetch operation you'll perform using cursor, okay, to fetch the result or to fetch the individual row from the result set, we will use the cursor. Now we'll see the syntax of this cursor. We have a declare section, okay, so declare cursor name. So first you use the declare keyword, then provide the cursor name, okay, and there is option insensitive. So what is this insensitive? Insensitive means the cursor will act as though it is accessing a private copy of the result. Okay, so it will just act as a pointer to a private copy of the result. So even though you modify some of the content to the base relation, that will not be reflected once the cursor is open. Okay, and scroll means like by default cursor will point to the next row. Okay, after fetching the first row, it will move to the next one. But if you set scroll, scrollable cursor means you can change the position. It is flexible. Okay, and withhold means the cursor will not be closed until the transaction commits. Maybe when you are performing the transaction, to maintain the consistency, we'll use the withhold option. Then we have for some query. So here you have to mention on which query you are writing, and then order by is used if you want to order or sort the rows according to a particular attribute value. Then we can use the order by clause. And then we have for read only or for update. So for read only means here the cursor is used only for fetching the tuples, just to access. Okay, you cannot update, you cannot perform updation or deletion on the result set. If you write for update means you can do deletion or updation. Now here you can see the example. First we will declare the cursor whose name is sinfo, and here the query is we are fetching the name at age of the sailors, whose rating is greater than the user specified rating. Okay, and then once the cursor is defined or it is declared, then you have to open the cursor. So open sinfo, and then when you write open sinfo, it will allocate the memory for that cursor. Then you fetch the values. That means now you start accessing one by one row from the result set. Okay, so fetch sinfo to CS name and CH. So here these two are the host variables. You can see here we have mentioned colon. That means we are fetching sinfo. Sinfo contains these two. This is pointing to a row which contains these two values. So that value, those values will be assigned to name and age variables. So once you have completed fetching all the rows, then you can close the cursor. So using close sinfo. Now we can see the example for cursor, like how we can use the cursor in embedded SQL. Here again the C program we have taken. What we will do here, first we will enter some random number, not entering, just we will take some random number for the user defined minimum rating, and then here we will compare whether rating is greater than user specified rating. Okay, and sort this rows or arrange these rows according to name of the seller. Okay, so you can see here whatever variable you want to use with respect to your host language, those can be defined within declare section. Okay, within declare section you can declare or you can put the variables which you want to use in your program. And then here, okay, you will execute this query. Okay, when you open the cursor, so it will execute this query, and now it is pointing to the first row of the result. Okay, because we have not mentioned a scrollable. After this, we will assign the values to sname and age, and will print these values. Okay, so here instead of executing in the SQL query, it is not returning on single tuple. Instead of that, it is returning multiple tuples. Okay, so using cursor, we can bridge the gap between multiple set result and your host variable. Then once it is done, how we can check whether it has reached the last row? So we'll take SQL state. Okay, SQL state, if it is not equal to 0200, so this code is related to data not found. Okay, so if it is not equal to this error code or the state, then continue. Otherwise, you have reached the end of this result set. You come out from this loop and close the cursor. Okay, so using close sinfo, you close the cursor. Now we have a dynamic SQL. See, in the previous cases, we know what is the query we want to execute. If you go for embedded SQL, there you will type or you will specify, this is the query, for this I want the result, and I want to do some operations on the result of this query. But if you don't know what actually you want to execute, what is the query string or query statement, if you don't know, you want to give that during the runtime. Okay, so you will give that during the runtime and you will execute. In that case, we can use the dynamic SQL. So in dynamic SQL, at runtime, you will specify what is the query. Okay, and that query will be processed in your program. Okay, so dynamic SQL allows programs to construct and submit executing SQL statements, queries at runtime. Okay, and here program takes SQL statements from the keyboard at runtime, and it may be like a point and click operation which translates to some SQL queries. So whatever you type at runtime, so that query will be considered, or that query will be translated and then it will be executed. Okay, so that is the concept of dynamic SQL. If you see this example here, I'll use SQL update string. This is the variable which will hold the SQL query statement or the string, query string. Okay, now enter the query string. So it is asking enter update command. Okay, and then you will specify what is the query string. At runtime you will specify what is the query string, and that query string will be passed, and this prepared statement will pass, and it will convert, or it will make ready with the SQL statement. It will just check what is the query and what is, whether there is any syntactical error. So all these things it will check, and it will mount that to the SQL command. So here SQL command, actually it is one of the variable or SQL variable, and to this the query will be assigned. Okay, and then you will execute this command using exec SQL execute. So here prepare means it will just parse, or it will translate the query string to executable query, and then execute SQL command, it will execute that SQL query. Okay, and then here in your C program, how you can write this? So first you take the command statement or the query statement. This is the query: update account set balance equal to balance into 1.05, where account number equal to question mark. Now what is this question mark? So this is the placeholder. Okay, this is the placeholder. So if you give value for this, if you enter the account number, so that account number will be assigned to this. Okay, now here you can see I have put the question mark over here, and then we'll prepare the SQL variable, my program, and it will be prepared with the command. In SQL command, what we have? We have this query statement. Okay, so it will check, and it will create a executable SQL command, and that will be there in my program. And then account number you have specified, so it will just check, or it will assign that account number is 101 to this account number. Then execute. So execute my program using account. What is there in account? A101. So that value we are assigning to this at the runtime. Okay, so as I said, the question mark is a placeholder. So in this way you can specify, or you can provide the SQL query at runtime. Okay, so here just I have explained what all the things you can use when you are writing the application program. Like you can embed the commands in high level languages, and then you have a cursor concept. Like if you have a multiple set or written in the SQL command, then how you can access those tuples. So for that we are using a mechanism called cursor, and then we have glanced the concept of embedded SQL and dynamic SQL. Thank you.